The Health Ministry was not aware that Plantation Industries and Commodities Minister Khairuddin Aman Razali had breached COVID-19 quarantine rules after he returned from Turkey on July 7th for several weeks, until they were informed about it last week. This is what Health Ministry Director General Dr Noor Hisham Abdullah told a press conference this evening.
All of us here were not informed. We only been informed last week. And what we did, the first thing is to instruct internal investigation. And yesterday only I got the report from internal investigation, a full report, what happened from the ground, and we were not informed. So it's very important for our frontliners, whatever happened at the ground level, to inform us or inform the superior so that action can be taken as soon as possible. But more importantly today is under police investigation. So police is also part of our enforcement under the Act 342. So under Section 3, we already empowered the police. Thereby, the public officer, police, AG, they are also part of the enforcement of the Act 342. So we will leave the police to do all the investigation and take the necessary action. So I hope that the police will do a good job and then address this issue as soon as possible.
Dr. Hisham was also asked whether Khairuddin was accompanied by his family and whether his entourage were also screened.
Second, as I said, the case is related, it's a police case. We leave it to the police to investigate further, to come up with an official report and etc. So we are also in the dark because we only got to know last week. So internal investigation has been done. I've seen the report and then the report has been given to the police.
Meanwhile, Dr. Noor Hisham announced that Malaysia reported 11 new COVID-19 cases today, with 9 cases being locally transmitted. The remaining 2 were imported. From the 9 local cases, a bulk came from Kedah, with 7 cases, with 5 linked to the Tawah cluster. Selangor and Perlis also saw 1 new case in each state, respectively. The new cases bring the size of the Tawah cluster to 70 cases. The 5 new Tawah cluster cases today involve students in a primary school in the state.